to our final gold medal bout in the men's under 80 kilogram category with a number one seed, Saif Issa from Egypt, from the Republic of Korea again, Kang Min-woo. Italy's Mauro Sarmiento, a silver and bronze medalist from Beijing and then London. He was saying this was his weight category and he used to like to analyse his opponents as much as possible. But you couldn't always do that with the finals coming so soon after the semis, so you have to use this first round to try and sound out your opponents, see what they've got in their locker. That is what is just going through the minds of these two. You see a little bit of distance being conducted between these two. Kang making sure that he's out of range if he needs to be, if Issa comes forward, and another grab of the lower body by Issa. Tries to come in, tries to break the distance with that front foot. Distance all important in taekwondo. How close you fight the fight to your opponent. Kang trying to cut that distance. That's the end of the first, 0-0 after 2 minutes. On paper, there is only one winner. It is the man in the blue. Out on the mat, things are very different. We are still tied up after 2 minutes. Attempt at the back leg turning kick, but he thought better of it. Yeah. Feinting from Kang, trying to lull his opponent into coming forward and then potentially striking with a back kick or catching him unawares somehow. It's first 2 points of the fight go to the Korean. Now another two added on. Four, all of a sudden, points ahead. 30 seconds just over remaining in the second round. Kang having made the move. The Republic of Korea with one gold medal just sewn up in the women's under 57 kilograms. Kim Yoo-jin, can Kang Min-woo follow on? He's against the number one seed here in Naples in the under 80 kilogram category. You can see the difference in height between the two, and Saif Issa just hasn't been able to make that pay. He's going to have to chase the fight in the final 2 minutes. Kang Min-woo playing a very clever fight so far to negate the extra leg differential which he's chasing down on his Egyptian opponent. Four points is just a spinning kick to the trunk protector away from being all square. Also take the lead straight off with 5 points from a spinning head kick. He's well within touching distance. There he goes with the back kick to the trunk. Not landing. Fighters in the open stance, the right leg of the Egyptian against the left front leg of Kang, trying to go for a shot to the head straight on. Jabbing out with the left and establishing the distance again. The creep begins. Then the spinning kick is tried to be planted. Again, Kang was aware it was coming, moved out the way well. The Egyptian needing to chase this. Tries to go with a crescent, but the distance was closed superbly by the Korean. Big back leg turning kick, which lands. 3 points. Just 1 point difference now. 30 seconds remaining. It goes for the punch in on the clinch. That shot to the head from Isa, putting this final well within his reach. It's going to come down to the last 20 seconds. Now they're all square. Point landed via the punch. Two of the judges marking it up for the Egyptian. Can he go one more? Can this be done in the third round by the Egyptian? Starting the round 4 points down. Can coming forward looking for points. They won't land. We will be in to the golden round. Well, what a round from that man. Knew what he had to do. Back leg turning kick, which scored him the points. There it was, right round, clipping the ear. And they're coming in for the clinch straight after to prevent any retaliation. And that was the punch which gave him that 1 point. And he closed the distance well to land that. And you have to show the judges a full punch. It can't be a half punch or just a small amount of power. You've got to show as much extension as you can. So, the rules of the golden round. It is the first to land 2 points. That could be two gamjons, could be two punches. Score 2 points and the fight will be over. Nothing registering. Just a minute. Rarely does it go all the way. The Egyptian, who's on the comeback trail. In the third round, can he complete the job? Coming in close, trying to land it with a back leg turning kick, then going to the front, and it's opponents on the floor. He'll get a gamjon. Just the 1 point, another gamjon, and that would be it. Victory to the Egyptian, but Kang's still alive, 30 seconds. Kang on the creep, tries to land the shot to the trunk protector. He goes to the head. It is points to the Korean. He has his arms in the air. He has the victory. He has the gold medal. Momentum with the Egyptian, but the shot landing on the trunk protector. Kang Min-woo is the champion.